This actually the only site that we have found and excavated so far, showing us the power of the kingdom of King David and Solomon that was missing up until they found this site about 10 years ago. Hello to the Israel Collective people. Yoav, your tour guide in Israel, is here. Why did I come over here? One of the most amazing things that is happening here, right where I'm standing, is giving us the ability to understand and actually to see the reality of the Bible much better and prove the Bible. For many years, we had a hard time to prove the kingdom of King David and Solomon with archaeological material. Archaeologists did not find anything outside of Jerusalem that is showing us the size and what we read about in the Bible about their kingdoms. In the year 2007, two archaeologists came over here to where I'm standing and started hitting the ground, and first thing they find are some olive pits. They're sending it to carbon dating and they find out these olive pits are dated to the 11th century BC and to the 10th century BC, which fits perfectly to the time of King David. When they start excavating, they immediately find this gate where I'm standing here, and you can see the place where the door was actually located. What they found over here can be done only by a strong kingdom. When we come over here, we firstly assume that maybe the Philistines are the people that are building this city, but we do not find any material that belongs to the Philistines. No, not the pottery and not other things. What else they don't find here? They don't find pig bones. And who don't eat pigs? The Jews. This was the front where David fights Goliath, is the front of the meeting place between the Philistines coming from the coastal plain and the Israelites coming from the hill country. This land around us, the Ela Valley where the Israelites are parking, is a very fertile land. This land is a very important land to feed the people in Jerusalem, but also in the coastal plain. This is why they fight for it. So we came all the way to here, to the southern part of the site, and I'm standing in another gate that was used for this city that we haven't said what its name yet, a city that was existing during the time of David. Now, the fascinating part of the site is that we know its name. We know its name because it's mentioned in the scripture right after David kills Goliath. If you go to verse 52, again, 1 Samuel 17, you will read, "The men of Israel and Judah arose and shouted and pursued the Philistines as far as the valley and to the gate of Ekron, and the slain Philistines lay along the way to Shaaraim." Ooh, Shaaraim. "Even to Gath and Ekron." If you knew Hebrew, you knew that the word Shaaraim is first of all a name of a place. Someone, by the way, is assuming we know these locations because that's the way how it's written. The Bible was written to someone who knows the geography. But the Hebrew language helps us to understand the geography even better over here. The word Shaaraim means two gates. Where am I? I'm at Shaaraim, the two-gated city. I am Yoav Rotem, a tour guide here in Israel. And Shaaraim, where I'm standing, is a site that shows us and proves us that the Bible is real.